Hi, my name is Darren. Welcome to Crash. Wait, oh, sorry, cannot say that. Okay. Have you ever wondered about the origin stories of laws in Singapore? Well, look no further. Here we're going to do a quick run through of some of the origin stories of three laws in Singapore. Let's begin. Law number one. Section 377A of the Penal Code. I'm sure plenty of you have heard these three numbers and one letter before. And if you haven't, Section 377A of the Penal Code in Singapore is a law that criminalizes sexual acts between two men, consensual or otherwise, in public or in private. Like how we spell colour, the origins of 377A of the Penal Code is rooted in the British Empire. Singapore's Penal Code was originally borrowed, copied, from the Indian Penal Code, which the British-controlled India started practicing in 1862. Till this day, it's still the primary criminal statute in Singapore. Some changes have been made, but it still forms the foundation of law in Singapore. In the original Penal Code, Section 377 states, "Whoever voluntarily has carnal intercourse against the order of nature with any man, woman, or animals shall be punished with imprisonment for life, or with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 10 years, and shall be also liable to fine." But it wouldn't be until 1938 that Section 377A was added in the Straits Settlements, which includes Singapore. One of the main reasons for 377A's enactment was to stamp out prostitution, in particular, male prostitution. But recent declassified documents have also suggested that racism may have played a part in its enactment. At the time, many prominent European men, some of whom were in the civil service and government, were engaging in sexual acts with male natives of Singapore and Malaya. Sir Thomas Shenton, yes, that Shenton, the governor of the Straits Settlement, did not like that at all. So he introduced 377A into the Penal Code. To save his men from embarrassment, he specifically stated that British officials were to be given a chance to resign and leave the colony before being brought to court. The natives, however, were not given such chances. Fast forward to 1965, when Singapore gained independence, Section 377A and its mother statute 377 were kept in the Penal Code. To sum it up, 377 covered men, women, and animals. Section 377A only covered men. Many years later, Section 377 was also repealed and rewritten, and now criminalizes any sexual acts with human corpses. Law number two, the Societies Act. The Societies Act was introduced as the Societies Ordinance. The law was first passed in 1889 and then came into effect on Jan 1st, 1890. Even in the 19th century, secret societies were prominent in Malaya. New immigrants are incentivized to join these societies because they provide assistance, protection, a sense of kinship, and spiritual fulfillment. Things of which might be considered very important in a new land. However, intense rivalries within and between secret societies and the virtually unchecked influence of the secret societies contributed to a state of disorder. Some of these clashes amounted to public riots in the Straits Settlements between 1845 and 1885. The last straw came in 1887 when W.A. Pickering, the first protector of the Chinese, was severely wounded in an attack allegedly incited by the Gi Hok Society. With the backing of the then governor of the Straits Settlements, Cecil Clementi Smith, yes, that Clementi, and the colonial office, the new policy of suppression was committed to law with the passing of the Societies Ordinance. Under its provisions, societies of more than 10 members were deemed illegal unless they had obtained official approval and were registered with the government. In addition, the government was authorized to ban and dissolve any society it considered unlawful. The current Society Act draws heavily from this, expanding what constitutes a society. According to the Act, a society is defined as a club, company, partnership or association of 10 or more persons, whatever its nature or object, and not already registered under any other law. Law number three, maintenance of the Parents Bill. The last one is not a very old law, but it's the only law in Singapore history that's introduced by a nominated member of parliament and passed. The bill states, any person domiciled in Singapore who is unable to maintain himself adequately may apply to a district court for an order that one or more of his children may pay him a monthly allowance or lump sum for his maintenance. It was first introduced on May 23, 1994 by Associate Professor Walter Woon. Woon highlighted that the aim of the bill was to provide a safety net if filial piety fails. He argued that the law provided a way for a small group of parents that are in these situations to seek recourse against children if these parents genuinely cannot provide for themselves. The introduction of the bill generated heated debate in the media and in parliament. Those that opposed the bill felt that Singapore's Asian values were sufficient to ensure that children would take care of their parents and that there was no need for legislation. Others were afraid that the law would replace moral obligation with legislation. However, Woon said in his speech that the law was not meant to replace filial piety, but to ensure that filial piety is not the only solution to society's problems. He argued that if a child had good relationship with their parents would not take them to court. He said, "It's only in families where the bond has already broken down that there is a possibility of litigation. So having such a law is not going to weaken strong bonds." In the end, the second reading of the bill had passed with 50 MPs voting for and 13 MPs voting against or abstaining. It was then sent to a select committee for further consideration. It was eventually passed in Parliament on November 2nd, 1995. and the legislation came into operation on November 24th that year. So those were just some of many, many laws in Singapore. And there are many other interesting laws with curious origins as well. Are there more laws you want to know about? Maybe why it's illegal to be naked in your own home? Tell us in the comments and we might dive into it for another video.